The Fuel to the Fire Showcase. Alex Anderson and Tipton Rosemark takes on South Haven, Chandler Jackson and Christian Brothers, Has Bartlett, Kinley Chandler and Briarcrest. They have Peril Cone, their top 40 in Tennessee, Marcus Fitzgerald that was at Brentwood, and then Lausanne, they got to take on White Haven. No need to talk about the Haven and what the Tigers can do. This is the one everybody was talking about. Lausanne is packed in like sardines, and there's a special guest in the building. Penny Hardaway, I gotta give it up to God. Man, oh man, I've been a huge fan of that guy as well as my dad for as long as I can remember, and for him to walk into the gym, whew, chills go through my body. Big time basketball out at Lausanne Collegiate School here in the Memphis area. Holly Springs from Mississippi is in the building, and they are no snubs. Corey Bell, Derek Fountain, Taheem Reeves. I mean, they are just loaded like a baked potato. Bacon, sour cream, onions, and ranch. Put it all on the baked potato. It's going to be good. But who's going to start it off? No other than Lausanne. Jonathan DeJohnette getting an easy bucket in the paint on the offensive end for his squad to start off with the Lynx. But I told you, Corey Bell, a walking buck, the 6-foot guard on the Holly Springs Hawks, gets the first bucket to go for them. And then what about this freshman? I love his game. Antonio Dilworth, 5'10 freshman, had a big-time game for Lausanne. A putback down low for the big and DeJohnette. He gets another two for the tap-in, and then next time down, they said, all right, you got enough. This, get this block. And then they actually called for a foul. DeJohnette heads to the free throw line. The other side, though, Reeves gonna knock down the three right in the face of the defense. I mean, you can get no closer than that. And they said, oh, that was a floozy the last time you knocked that one down. Let me let you get another one. Well, he took it from the same spot, same result. Bell's gonna get it off to the big. It's gonna be an easy lay-in for him. That's Anthony Gulledge Jr. with an easy two down low. And then looking to slam it back over the defense's head. DeJohnette missing that one. Bo Montgomery gonna lob it up to the big. Musa getting called for the travel. It's going on the other side, and then they actually miss, so they get another opportunity on Lausanne's side. They missed the jumper, but it's a tap back in for Montgomery. He actually got a milestone, got the career ball, 1,000 points in Lausanne's history. So you know he came to do work. There's another easy two for him. Reeves gonna look down low, gets it blocked in the paint by Musa. It's 13-10 to start it off. Lausanne's got a 3-point lead heading into the second quarter. First play out the gate, though, Musa tries to take flight the long way. He can't get it to go, but boy, oh boy, that would have been amazing. Here's Taheem Reeves once again. Look at him, just locked, loaded, and ready, not talking Smith and Wesson. This guy here can let it ride, and I mean from deep. Bo Montgomery gets the feed off, and he takes flight. Move off the runway, you got a flying guard coming through. He gets an easy two, and then Dilworth Jr. goes to the bucket for another layup for the Lynx. On the other side, Reeves goes up. He misses. There's a tap back, though. He's clearing up the boards. That's Dylan King for the two for the Hawks. On the other side, they make the skip pass over to Antonio. He's called for an offensive foul. The freshman gets his first offensive foul of the game. And then King says, no, 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 I didn't get enough the last time. Let me get another two. He finishes with the left, and next time he comes down with the right. I mean, King is turning up. And not just him. Look at the fans just locked in. This is what you want to see. You want to see your fans there supporting you, especially when you're sitting right across from a student section that's jumping up and down going crazy. Oh, they're not going to sit back and wait on that, though. Here is Corey Bell going to the cup, crossing over, finish with the right off the glass, making it look so easy. He can just put it right into the oven and cook it up for an easy two. There is a block by Derek Fountain, goes out of bounds. No easy buckets in here, young fella. I know you're a freshman, but you're going to have to learn the game the hard way. That's what Derek Fountain says. So he gets that block to go, an easy two for Musa. And Derek Fountain, well, I think that's when he got locked in, man. When he started talking trash, he starts blocking down there. I mean, yeah, it's right before the half, but take a look at the second half. Derek Fountain is just going to go crazy. Let's jump into it, though. Third quarter of this matchup. Come out in the gates. going to be Reeves kicking it over to none other than Derek Fountain. I told you, going into the locker room, he had all the intensity on the offensive end. Defensive end, he was blocking shots. Came out in the third quarter and knocked down the three. This time, he's going to give it off to the PG, and he gets it right back. Swinging through, pull-up jumper right in the face of the defense. This Derek Fountain kid is amazing. I'm not sure if he plays like this every night, but the two times that I've seen him, he's gone bonkers. So I can tell you one thing. He's been back-to-back legit in the face of my eyes. And when I walk in the gym and I see a kid that's playing like this night in, night out for the times that I see him, well, I can just say he's a lethal monster. Knockdown jumper from outside for Hayden Ledbetter. You know he can knock that thing down from anywhere. And then look at the student section. Get Bullen out the broom. They're trying to sweep Holly Springs, but Corey Bell not letting that happen. Musa says, let me change your mindset. He about grabs the thing out the entire goal, and then on the way down tries to do the 360 slam. Can't get that one to go, though. Bo Montgomery knocking down a jumper mid-range style, and then Bell goes up, still blocked by the big, but also called for goaltending. An easy two right there for Holly Springs. It's going to be a night down three for Reeves in the corner for Holly Springs. Dilworth Jr. is going to find Dylan over in the corner. He takes a dribble, floats it up right over the iron for a two. It's good to go for the Lynx. Dylan's going to look down low to Bo. He gets it right back outside the wing, goes up and under off two defenders to go off the glass, and it's a two-pointer for the Lynx. The PG kicks it right back over. It's a knockdown three, and he's locked in, baby. Dylan Andrews born back to back like Drake. I mean, he's just going crazy right now. Coach Davis trying to lock his team in, says, let's go. Let's get the push here. And then Musa comes up. I mean, it's nothing. You can get around the rim against this kid. And then he's getting rebounds and putting it right back up like it's just easy. 47-44. It was a 13-3. Point swing to open up the third quarter. I mean, Lausanne's clicking on all cylinders here to start it off. Called for an offensive foul. It's going the other way back to Lausanne. The fans not liking that one. They said, how could that possibly be an offensive foul? And he failed. Corey Bell gets a steal on the defense. He goes up, almost blocked, misses that one. It does get tapped, though. Going to get called for goaltending. They're going to cap that two off. Dylan Andrews going to go to the bucket for a two over two defenders. And then Reeves outside for another three. I mean, this Taheem Reeves is just one bad player. He's super good on the offensive and defensive end, but look at this pass. I mean, you say Reeves can only score. Look at that lefty pass, threading the needle with under a minute to go. Lausanne only up by one. It's starting to get nitty gritty. Goes out of bounds. It's going the other way. Holly Springs comes up with it, and it almost goes out. They get stuck. Great defense by Musa. It's going to get called for a timeout. They get another opportunity. Derek Fountain feeds it off. It's going to be a block. Musa holding his head like no way possible. I mean, ref, how long have you been doing this? I just can't see myself fouling right there. But I'll tell you one thing. Holly Springs couldn't knock either one of them down. The student section was right in front of his face, and they just couldn't get him to get an easy free throw. He missed two of them. On the other end, a freshman is opening up eyes. He knocks down the first one, but misses the second. Derek Fountain, though, he's not going to sleep. Wake him up, young fella. Go down there and put him in a spin cycle and knock it down short, elbow, and get your fans on their feet. Look at them. All smiles, cheese, and popcorn in their teeth. It's a big-time night. Pull-up jumper from downtown. It's missed. It took us to overtime. We're going to open it up, though. The give and go. Up and off the glass, getting blocked, and then call him a little boy. Put his hand down on his head like, get down away from me. Gulich Jr. with an easy two. Hayden Ledbetter getting a knockdown jumper from outside. He getting talking a little trash. And then Anthony once again missing that one, going up. Musa there to block two of them bad boys. A kick over to the corner. That's airballed. Rebound by Musa. He goes up. right over the iron, no glass needed for an easy two for Musa Cisse. And then a pull-up jumper. Look at this. This is just Carmelo Anthony. I mean, what status do you want to say? That's just James Harden. That's just, I mean, who else? Dirk Nowitzki. I mean, this kid here is amazing. Derek Fallon with the pull-up short corner jumper right in the face of the defense, fading away. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Musa heads to the free throw line, though. 23.1 seconds to go. Lausanne up by two, make it three. Three-point lead. Derek Fallon pulls up. It's missed off the back iron and taps. Almost goes out of bounds, and it gets hit. It's returned and saved by Lausanne. They head to the free throw line. The point guard cannot get it to go. The second one is up and good. 64-60. Kickoff. It's a block. It's going to end it all. Lost Lausanne there to save the day. The student section storms the floor, and it's a dub. Derek Fallon and Holly Springs can't get it. Jalen Bowe walks into the career night of 1,000 points. At the Ultimate South Showcase. Hey, before you go, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and as well as click the bell to get the notification when Ultimate Preps uploads again.